Bezat Hashem, with Hashem's loving grace, this is Laser Brody, your host on Emunah Beams. Today's podcast is entitled Mashiach and COVID-19. You know, COVID-19 could also be called the undemocratic COVID-19, because democratic is an adjective that indicates liberty and free choice. Undemocratic, therefore, indicates a lack of free choice. We have to understand, though, that sometimes a lack of free choice is necessary for our own welfare. When many organizations around the world are protesting the breach on civil liberties that governments are allegedly making by locking things down and limiting movement during this pandemic period, which in many places like Israel and Florida and Texas is even worse than it was in the beginning. But there are times when a governing body must act for the good of public welfare. Otherwise, many people would use their free choice to spread the virus, especially if they were allowed to mingle indiscriminately with one another in crowded places. COVID-19, like everything else, not only comes from Hashem, but is Hashem's emissary to prepare the world for Mashiach and Geula, the redemption of the Jewish people and the gathering of the exiles to our beloved homeland in Israel. In fact, you could say that COVID-19 is the minister of education because it teaches people what they should have learned on their own. Let's look at the lessons that coronavirus is bringing to the world. The first one is Shmiras Negiah, guarding our hands and abstaining from touching anything that we're not supposed to. People now understand that touching anyone outside their immediate family unit is like playing Russian roulette. A man doesn't have to give an excuse anymore if he doesn't want to shake a woman's hand or vice versa. Young people in Shidduchim understand that if they want to stay healthy, they better not touch the person they're going out with. So if we don't have the sense to uplift ourselves and enhance holiness on our own, Hashem sends the Minister of Education, COVID-19, to heighten the incentive. Well, the second is Shmiras Aloshin, guarding our tongues and refraining from speaking detrimentally about anyone, whether true or not. Between social distancing and the masks on our mouths, both courtesy of the Minister of Education, COVID-19, we gossip a lot less and talk a lot less. That's healthy, because our sages say that the bulk of our speech should be devoted to Torah learning and prayer anyway. The third is Shmiras Haguf, guarding our personal hygiene. Before the pandemic, many people were lax in washing their hands first thing in the morning, or before after eating, or before after the bathroom. Now people are washing their hands not only at prescribed times, but all day long in order to stay healthy. Well, these three types of shmira, of guarding ourselves, have become a lot stronger since COVID-19 came on the scene. Also, another type of shmira, a fourth type, about guarding the food we eat, has really become important because we found out how the COVID spread in China from all these things that the Torah forbids from eating. So by enhancing our observance of the kashrus laws, it also enhances our guarding our bodies and our holiness and our protection from coronavirus. The health department directives that unintentionally make us more careful about social distancing and guarding ourselves from becoming sick, a lot of people laughed at them. They didn't wake up in the first wave, and now they have to wake up in the second wave of COVID-19. So if you don't learn on your own, then the Minister of Education, COVID-19, he comes and he teaches. Why the COVID-19 limitation of our free choice? Isaiah the prophet tells the whole story in chapter 60 of his prophecy, which describes exactly what the world will look like when Mashiach and Geula come. It will be a great time, but it's our choice how it will come. Isaiah concludes chapter 60 with two famous words, Be'ita Achishena, which means I shall hasten it in its time. Hashem declares, I am Hashem, I shall hasten it in his time. That Hashem is talking about is the Geula. That's what Hashem's talking about. That's what he's referring to. So why does Hashem have to tell us, I am Hashem? And why does he sound like he's contradicting himself? Either he's going to hasten it or bring it in his time. Well, the Rambam gives us the answer to the first question. When Hashem says, I am Hashem, he's reminding us that everything comes from him and from a good reason, as we learn in our first principle of Emunah. He alone did, does, and will do every deed. COVID-19 is no exception. Like everything else, it comes right from Hashem and for the very best to make sure that we're spiritually prepared for Mashiach and Geula. Rashi gives the answer to the second question. It seems the contradiction between hasten it or coming on time. Rashi says that if we merit, Hashem will hasten the Geula in a trouble-free fashion. But if we don't merit, in other words, if we don't strengthen our Emunah and our sincere mitzvah observance on our own accord, Hashem will bring the Geula in its own time anyway. no matter what it takes to do so. That's why no one is succeeding in outsmarting COVID-19, because it's Hashem's minister of education to teach us that if we want to be capable of receiving light of Mashiach, we have to enhance emunah and our personal holiness and guarding the mitzvahs, the shmiras, the different guardings that we spoke about, and the undemocratic COVID-19 force us to guard our hands, our personal hygienes, and our mouths, and what comes in our mouth and what comes out of our mouth. And if we add to that guarding our eyes, which also COVID can enter the eyes, Hashem will let us see Mashiach in the Gula and our rebuilt Holy Temple in the nearest future, speeding our days. Amen. God bless.